Welcome to the NetRepper's Chemist and Drugstore Management System Plus. This is a lifetime license software and it works on any Windows operating systems like Windows 7 or 10 or any LAN systems from Windows 2014 onwards. There is no monthly or annual subscription and you are the owner for full version and all of software is installed in your system. This software comes from an established organization with over 2 decades of services, and this software is in use in over 20 countries worldwide with over 10,000 clients and growing. For download the software, first we have to go through our website and click on that product which you want to buy and click on buy now. Or you can buy from Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal or Paytm also. If you are international customer, so you can convert price into USD, and if you want to get a CD, so click on add CD shipping charges, then click on buy now. After that we have to add all details on the buy now page and select any payment gateway, or you can click on generate invoice for online payment. You will get a checkout page. Click on checkout, you will get a payment page. And after giving payment, the message will be coming for download the software in link or your email also. Click on that link and download it. After downloading the software, or when you get a CD or DVD version, you will have a zip folder. Extract the file at location in your system and open the folder to locate installation guide. Please follow all 3 steps one after another in order of 1, 2 and 3 steps for successful installation of software. First step for checklist before installation. Second step for SQL Server installation guide. And third for product installation guide. During the installation of third step, you will be asked to enter product key. This you can find in your register email when you download it, or as a text file in the CD or DVD. Now I am going to take you through the software to show how easily you can operate the software. After installation, you will find a desktop icon and on click, you will get a screen to create an administrator who will have complete rights on all process of screens. You can set up an ID and password here and remember it for login anytime later. Now we have to write your username, ID, and password, give the status, give the user permission for that user, click OK. Details are saved. Here you can write your organization details, write your organization details, select logo of your organization, then submit it. Details are saved. Write a user ID and password and login it. Now go to the administration module, write your user ID and password and login it. You can now add additional users, doctors, specialties, lab tests in each of the setup screens as you find in the setup and administration module as shown in the screen here. In setup users, here you can add additional users. Here you can set up specialties details. Here you can set up consultant details. Here you can set up lab department details. Here you can set up corporate companies details. Here you can set up investigations details. Here you can set up insurance company details. Here you can set up insurance contract details. Here you can set up packages. Here you can set up configuration of SMS and email details. All screen in the software will have add, update, search, print and quit, so that you can update and patient data anytime based on user permissions. Now go to the inventory module, login it using ID and password. Here you can add the details for fixed assets, current assets and consumable assets also. For fixed assets, for item master, you can add here the item details. In supplier, here you can save the details of vendors. In purchase order, here you can add the details of purchase orders. In receiving, for receiving with purchase order or without purchase order, you can add the details for it. In receiving history, here you can search the receiving history. In discarded items, here you can save the discarded items details. In stock details, here you can search the details of stock. You can add details for current assets and consumable assets also. Here you can set up the opening balance. Now go to the main page. In registration module, in new registration, now I will show you how to register a patient. Firstly, you need to select the category which can be general, corporate or insurance patient based on their payment mode. Secondly, you need to enter patient details, or at the minimum entries can be shown here, or else if you want you can add all details in the screen now or later. Now I am writing here patient details. Give the investigation details. Give the personal information. Give the sample collection information. And save it. So details are saved. You will getting print of this report here. In referral registration, using this screen you can add the details of referral doctor's details. In search module, you can search the patient details here. In investigations, in investigations result, here you can give the investigation result to the patient. Select patient name. Select investigation code. Give the normal values. You can add here image also. Give the test done by. And save it. So details are saved. You will getting print of this report here. In combining reports, using this screen you can combine the reports of patient. Select patient name, check patient test and print it. You will getting print of this report here. In cancel investigation, using this screen you can cancel the investigation of patients. In pending investigation search, here you can search the pending investigation of patient. In reports module, here you can find more than 100 reports in this report module. Just I show you for list. You can search all the summary reports here. In utilities, in installation setting, you can edit your organization details here. In backup manager, here you can backup your data or entries into separate location or in CD or portable drive or pen drive anytime on periodically of weekly, monthly, 3 months or yearly, so that you can restore them back later when ever want it. In voucher payments, using this screen you can give the voucher payments to the staff and others. In receipts, using this screen you can give the receipts to the patients. Now go to the pharmacy management. In central pharmacy, login it using ID and password. In manage location, here you can add the location name of drugs. Here you can add the drugs details. Here you can manage the supplier. Here you can add the patient details. Here you can add the pharmacy list of client pharmacies. Here, using this screen, you can manage the purchase orders. Here, you can manage the receivings with or without purchase order. Here, you can manage the supplier payments. Here, you can manage the issues of client pharmacies. Here you can manage the sales or rise bill to the patients. Select supplier name. Give the batch number. Give the number of packs at to read. Select patient name or add patient name. Give the details. And click on bill. So details are saved. You will getting print of this report here. In pending bills, here you can clear the pending bills of patient. In manage sales returns, here you can manage the sales returns. Here you can manage the purchase returns of supplier. Here you can manage the issue returns. Here you can search the drug details. Here you can set up the user or configure SMS and email. Here you can set up the opening balance. Here you can backup your data. Now go to the main page. Now go to the client pharmacy. Login it using ID and password. In manage indents, here you can manage the indents details. Here you can manage the receiving details which are coming from central pharmacy. Here you can manage the sales or rise bills to the patient. Select the barcode. Select drug name, select batch number, give the number of pack of drug. Select patient type, give the patient name, give the details. Click on bill, details are saved. You will getting print of this report here. In manage sales returns, you can return sales of a patient. Drug search, you can search the drug details here. In reports, you will get all summary reports here. In pending bills, you can clear the pending bills of patient. In issue returns, using these screens, you can return to the central pharmacy. In setting, ID and password here. Now go to the finance accounting system. Login it using ID and password. In administration, you can set up the categories details here. In create company, here you can create new company. Create general ledger, in setup general ledger. Here you can create a general ledger. In chart of account, you can search the account details here. In finance material purchase, in create purchase order, here you can create the purchase order. In receiving materials, here you can receive the items here. In vendor bills, here using this screen, you can pay the vendor's amount. In purchase returns, here you can return the items. In create sales invoices, using this screen, you can sell the items to the customers. In enter sales, here, using this screen, you can generate the customer payment receipt. In sales returns, here, you can return the sales items from customers. In voucher entries, in enter voucher, here you can add the voucher details. Select department name, cost center, voucher type. Select account type. Select sub account of. Select general account name. Give the bill type. Select bill status. Check the bills. Total amount will be coming. Then select bill type, give the patient general category. Click on add to grid and click save. So details are saved. You are getting print of this report here. In debit entries, here you can enter the debit details. Select department name, cost center, select debit type, give the account type, give the sub account of, give the general account name, give the details, click on add to grid and save it. Details are saved. You will get imprint of this report here. In credit entries, you can add the credit entries like debit entries, give the department name, cost center, credit type, give the account type, give the sub account of, give the general account name, give the amount and send it to grid. Click save. Details are saved. You will get imprint of this report here. In funds management, in bank receipt, here you will getting bank receipts. In bank receipt reconciliation, here we will get bank receipt reconciliation. Here you will get cash receipts. Here you will get cash receipt reconciliation. Here you can transfer the funds. In asset management, in create fixed assets, here you can create a fixed assets. Here you can fix the maintenance assets. Here you can set up a fixed asset depreciation. In setup budget and control, in setup budget category, you can add the budget category. Here you can set up the budget planning. In backup manager, here you can backup your data. In user creation, you can create a new user from the screen. In reports module, here you will get the balance sheet. You will get the print of this report here. Here you will get the profit and loss statements. Select the account, select name, and you will get the print of this report here. In trial balance, using this screen, you can print the trial balance. In close account, you can close the account from this screen. Now go to the HR management system. Login it using ID and password. In HR administration, in setup employee qualification, here you can add the qualification name. Here you can add the employee type name. Here you can add a designation name. Here you can add the leave name to the leave year. Here in employee staff registration, you can add the details. Give the employee detail, personal detail, salary detail, give the next of kin, remuneration, revision details, relieving details, and save it. In leave request entry, you can save the leave request entry details of employee. In air ticket entitlement, you can add the details of air ticket entitlement. For employee details, self trial detail, write a family trial detail and save it. In air ticket entitlement pending approval, you can save the pending approval of employee of air ticket entitlement. In manage offer letter, you can offer manage the offer letter of employee. You can add here details of employee, remunerations, personal particulars and next of kin. In manage end of service benefit, you can manage the end of service benefit of employee. You can add here the employee detail, salary calculations, outstanding leave calculations, indemnity. You can add here a ticket on permission deductions. In manage attendance, you can manage the attendance of the employees. Here you can manage the change the employee status. Here you can payslip generation of the employee. Here you will get HRM summary reports. Using this screen, you can create a new user. Here you can edit your organization details. Thank you for watching this video. Please note, you can get free training anytime at your convenience for you or your staff by calling on 9666-999-800 or 9666-999-885 or send an email request. Thank you.